Matter, anything that occupies space and has mass, is everywhere. Water, sushi, and your smartphone are all made of matter. All matter is made up of tiny particles called atoms, which are the basic building blocks of all molecules. They are so tiny that even the thinnest strand of human hair is a million times larger. Currently, we know of 118 different types of elements that are all made up of their specific type of atom. But what makes atoms of oxygen uniquely oxygen and atoms of hydrogen uniquely hydrogen? Well, to answer that, we first need to understand the structure of an atom, which was initially proposed by Ernst Rutherford around 1911. Previously, you may have learnt that atoms are the smallest unit of matter, but in our current model, atoms consist of three different types of subatomic particles: protons, electrons, and neutrons. Protons are positively charged particles, electrons are negatively charged particles, and neutrons are neutral particles with no charge. Protons and neutrons create the dense, positive charged center of the atom, known as the nucleus, and electrons are less densely dispersed around the nucleus. A positive proton has a charge of equal magnitude to a negative electron. So when the number of protons is equal to the number of electrons, the atom is neutral. In other words, the charges are of opposite sign and cancel. If the number of protons and electrons becomes unequal, then the atom becomes a positively or negatively charged ion. Now, inside your smartphone, there are silicon chips that process information and act like the brain of your phone. But how do we know on an atomic level that these silicon chips are made of silicon and that every atom is a silicon atom? Well, each element is defined by the number of protons in the nuclei of its atoms. So, every single atom of silicon has exactly 14 protons, and we say that silicon's atomic number is 14. Atomic number is abbreviated to Z, so you can say silicon Z is 14. No matter what silicon chip or piece of silicon you find, each atom composing it will have exactly 14 protons. If an atom has 15 protons, it is not silicon. It would be a phosphorus atom. And if an atom has 13 protons, it would be an aluminum atom. Now, what about neutrons? What are they, and how many neutrons does each element have? Neutrons have no charge and have a similar mass to protons. Most atoms of hydrogen have no neutrons. However, different atoms can have different numbers of neutrons without changing the identity of the element, because only the number of protons defines an element. Isotopes are forms of the same element that have different numbers of neutrons. For hydrogen, apart from the isotope with no neutrons, two other isotopes exist: one with one neutron and one with two neutrons. The atomic mass number, signified by a capital A, is the number of protons and neutrons in a particular atom. So, if an atom of hydrogen has one proton and two neutrons, its mass number A is 3. Since isotopes have different numbers of neutrons, they also have different masses and mass numbers. You might be wondering, why do we not include electrons in this mass number? This is because, compared to protons and neutrons, the mass of electrons is so small that it is insignificant in calculating an atom's mass. Nuclides, a name given to describe the number of protons and neutrons in a specific isotope of an atom, are identified and described with a specific naming system. In this nomenclature, we write the atomic symbol of the element, the value of the atomic number Z to the lower left of the atomic symbol, and the mass number A to the top left of the atomic symbol. So, for silicon 28, do you know what we would write? Pause the video and see if you can figure it out. First, we would write silicon's atomic symbol, SI. Then, since silicon has 14 protons, its atomic number 14 would go in the subscript. Finally, 28 goes in the superscript because it has 14 neutrons and 14 protons, so its mass number is 28. However, when looking at the periodic table, why is the atomic weight underneath silicon not a whole number like the atomic number? The answer is not that there is an additional fraction of a neutron inside silicon. Instead, the atomic weight seen on a periodic table, like 28.09 for silicon, takes into consideration all of the different natural isotopes of silicon. It is a weighted average of all of the isotopes of silicon. So atomic number looks at the specific whole number of protons and neutrons within an atom, while average atomic mass or atomic weight considers the masses of all the different isotopes of an element and creates a weighted average. The general formula for atomic weight is equal to the sum of the mass of each isotope multiplied by the percent of its natural abundance. This can also be written as M1P1 plus M2P2 and so on, where P is the fraction representing the natural abundance of the isotope and M is the mass number of the different isotopes. For example, the atomic weight of carbon is 12.01 because there is 99% 0.99 12C and 1% 0.01 13C. Even though natural carbon does not have a single atom with mass 12.01, when considering the mass of a sample of carbon in most chemical calculations, we act as if carbon only consists of one type of carbon with mass 12.01 atomic mass units. This atomic weight is measured in unified atomic mass units, which is written as lowercase u or dA for Daltons. 1 U is exactly 1/12 of the mass of a carbon atom with 6 protons and 6 neutrons. 1 U is then approximately the mass of a proton or a neutron. Now, even though the weight of an electron is tiny compared to protons or neutrons, the electron cloud around the nucleus makes up the vast majority of an atom's volume. The diameter of a nucleus made up of protons and neutrons is roughly 10 to the minus 13 centimeters in diameter, which is about 100,000 times smaller than the diameter of an atom when considering the electron cloud. So, let's summarize. Atoms are made up of the positive nucleus with a cloud of electrons surrounding it. The nucleus is densely packed with protons and neutrons. The number of protons in an atom defines what element it is. However, different isotopes of an element have different numbers of neutrons, so the mass of a single atom of an element will vary based on its number of neutrons. Finally, the atomic weight of an element depends on the relative abundance of its different isotopes.
Nilay's chemistry degree.